probably some of the best craft beer I've ever had.
Damn straight. No.
This is actually quite fun.
I slid a live dart, and this rod screamed off. I had a bite earlier, and we're almost ready to pack up, and this thing just burst off. It's way into the backing now, flying. It's so bright and it's a full moon. I'm very certain it's a blackfoot because I saw it jump there at the back there. So,
good size, eh?
Looks like a good sized fish. I think I'm gonna be busy for a while. Put more brakes and hang on.
Hold me, I'm going.
Hold me, hold me. On, mate! Aussie style. No Red Bull. Triple fish backing. Alright, so we are 20 minutes into the fight, and it's well into my backing, but I'm gaining, but quite a strong fish. So I think he's sitting somewhere in the back in a rib, and he's just hanging there. Every now and then he starts to take about 2 or 3 meters of line, but very strange. I don't know, seems weird. But that's the thing about these islands, you can hook anything, and I think it's best another way to get a number plate. Probably got this rod for about 5 years and absolutely love it. It casts very well, handles big fish. This rod must have seen over 5 tons of fish, or maybe even more, over the last couple of years. I think there's another bite there on the beach.
Oh, pull up. They said he's gonna strip you.
Come here!
You slow, man. Are you good, dude?
Yeah. I see what you mean about that.
Yeah, everyone thinks it's nice to be a showgirl.
He doesn't even know it's hooked yet. Yes, please! Daiwa! Got quite a bit of line back on my top shot, and fish went far right, and then I felt his head turn. Now he's heading left. We got some lines on that side, so I just want to clear them quickly. Not too far now, he's about another 100 meters out, give or take 100 meters. So we might get a number plate soon. I've got maximum pressure on this fish. The Saltiga 50HA has got a brilliant drag, very smooth. And obviously the 5.5 Kingfisher nylon, the giant abrasion, also very strong. So that's what allows me to put maximum pressure. So we can pull this fish as quick as we can. Probably on for about 35 minutes now. Won't be long.
Okay. Probably a check the cream markings, eh? And it's a lot bulkier. And look at this tail, guys. They all got this deformed funny tail. This is not a...
Got it.
Black tin.
It is not a dusky. It's 263119.
This is a different species.
We're not sure what species of shark this is, but we'll look it up and check it out. Almost like a blackfin sort of lemon shark, we're not sure. It's always, these sharks have sort of a off-shaped tail. We have seen some pictures of locals catching the same fish. Obviously it's a little bit smaller, so we'll figure it out.
Now we were really puzzled with this fish. It had some of the characteristics of a blackfin, a little bit of the dusky whaler, and afterwards when we had a look, the closest shark we could find was a possible sandbar shark. This fish, however, did have a couple of good jumps in the beginning of the fight. The squiggly tail just put us completely off track, but the closest ended up being a sandbar shark.
Okay, now, from the beginning.
Hit it, boys.